a lot of Chinese miners are holding their next gen equipment in storage instead of sending it over to the US, or I mean, but they're not liquidating, and they're also just like not moving it quite yet because it's also like prohibitively expensive to ship stuff right now. And so that is like a play that ASIC prices will continue to go up, and we're seeing that kind of affect the ASIC market right now. Wondering what you've heard about that from your contacts.
The ASIC supply chain right now is just totally borked. I mean, you can look at the secondary markets, you look at the primary markets, you can look at the number of contracts that have been canceled with like down payments or deposits that are just never going to be recovered.
I have a suspicion that I cannot validate it, that some of the larger Chinese miners knew it was coming. They already had stuff in the US in containers looking for a home. So if you do the math on that, what Austin said, you know, it's hard to get a container, they're expensive, it takes a long time to decommission a unit. So I think some of that hash, I think they found some homes for some of that, so some of that hash came back a little quicker.
I think it's a lot worse than a lot of people who are kind of fleeing China are alluding to. And my personal thesis is there's like a cabal of miners with this huge oversupply of ASICs that they can't find capacity to plug in, but they're slowly dripping them into the market to not crash the price so they can recover some of the capital, which I mean is what I would do, frankly. And so I think it's a little bit manipulated, number one. Number two, shipping prices like freight from China right now, I think the last quote that I saw was like 24 grand for a 20 foot standard ISO, which is insane. Last year there were 10 grand, which was still insane. Before that it was like 4,500, 5 grand. And even the container prices that like we see locally for new one-time use, like 20 foot standard or 40 foot standard, have gone up almost 250 to 300% since the last year, right? And so the supply chains all over the world are, as Marty likes to say, just borked out of control, right? And I don't think it's gonna recover anytime soon.